Today we're going to talk about wireless keyboard and mouse synchronization and how to re-synchronize your keyboard or mouse if you lose synchronization during the day. We're going to talk specifically about two of our keyboards and two receivers and our mouse. So the two different receivers that we have the blue receiver and we have the black receiver here. The blue receiver is our micro receiver, and that's all that you have on there, just blue. On the black receiver, we actually have a little light that will light up when you type or move the mouse and when you attempt to synchronize. So that's a good indicator of when the keyboard or mouse is synchronized. We'll show you how to do that. On the back of each of the keyboards, we have a blue connect button and the battery compartment. And here's the connect button and the battery compartment. And on the mouse, we also have a connect button. And that's how you would start the connection process. One of the most common causes of synchronization loss is dead batteries. And so we're going to open up the back of these, and you just slide the cover forward, and you'll see there's the two batteries there. And here are the two batteries in this one. And then in the mouse, it's really easy. What you want to do here is just lift up the back, and there's your batteries there. Whenever you replace batteries, you want to replace batteries in both the keyboard and the mouse at the same time, so that the time that you've replaced them, you can jot down somewhere so you know how long they've been in there. To cover these back up, it's pretty easy. The mouse is just held on by magnets. You push that down and it's good. And then these just slide back into place. The receiver that we have in here on the PC right now is the black one that has the light on it. And right now, I don't believe the keyboard is synchronized to it, so we're just going to push the Windows key, and no, it's not synchronized. So to synchronize, we're going to hold the keyboard close to where the receiver is, and the receiver's right down here. We're going to watch for that little blue light. You press and hold the connect button for about 5 to 10 seconds until you see the light. And if you don't have the black receiver and you have the blue one, then you hold for about 5 to 10 seconds and then it'll receive. If it doesn't light up then the next phase, and we'll check this out, see if it's synchronized. I missed it, I did not. So we're gonna remove the receiver, okay? And you hear the USB tone. We're gonna put it into a different USB port. And we're gonna push it all the way in. One of the things that might cause this to lose synchronization is if it gets bumped. And then it's loose in the slot, not all the way in. And we're gonna do the synchronization once more. So push and hold the button and look for the light. And there it is. And then we'll just test it to make sure. It sure is working. So there we have that one. For the mouse, it's the same deal. We're gonna push and hold that blue button and look for the blue light. And there it is. And now we should have the mouse, which we do. With the blue receiver, it's going to be the exact same thing. On the all-in-one PCs that we have a hidden USB port on some of them. Not all of them, but some of them. And we tend to ship this smaller blue receiver in those hidden USB ports. It's basically hidden behind a panel. And we'll show you right now on one of the all-in-ones where that's located to make it easy for you to find. When you're synchronizing keyboard and mouse with the wireless receiver, on some of our all-in-one PCs, we have a hidden USB port. Basically, hidden means behind a door somewhere. This is one of our 23-inch all-in-ones that has one of those hidden ports. and we're going to show you where that is today. So to look at this one, the angle is, or the way that you get to it is you angle it just up and away. It has a nice hinge on it. And then this is the door that it sits behind. It has two latches, one on each side, and then it pops off very easily. And there's your very easily. And then on the inside, you're gonna see the dongle right here. That's our receiver, and it comes out very easily. And that's your receiver. So if you need to reset or reseat the receiver, that's where it is. To put it back in, let's take a peek down there, get it in the right spot. Slides right back in, and there it is. If it doesn't work in this spot, you can actually take it out and insert it into one of the other USB ports that's on the side of the all-in-one. I hope that was useful. Thanks.